Hi, my name is Andrew Browne. I'm one of the retina specialists at Gavin Herbert Eye Institute. Thank you for joining us today for one of these age-related macular degeneration info bites. One of the questions that we frequently get asked is, why does my doctor choose to use Avastin versus Eylea versus Lucentis for treating wet age-related macular degeneration? Is there a very big difference between them? At the end of the day, all of these medications work extremely well. They work by stopping the effect of VEGF, which is a protein that promotes new blood vessel growth, blood vessel leakage, with a potential for bleeding in the retina. All of these medications have been used for years now, and the studies have shown that they all work extremely well. There are some differences in cost of the medication, where Avastin or bevacizumab costs somewhere in the order of $50 to $80 for an injection, whereas medications like Lucentis, ranibizumab, or Eylea, aflibercept, can cost in the order of $1,200 to $1,700. So there is some thought in terms of the cost of medications that a doctor might consider when counseling a patient on therapy. There are some small differences in the amount of the ability for the drug to dry out the fluid or leaking fluid in the retina. Eylea has shown in some diseases to be a little bit more strong in drying out leaking fluid in the retina. However, all of these medications work incredibly well. So the take-home message truly is, as long as you have wet, active macular degeneration, you should be receiving intravitreal or intraocular injections of one of these three medications because they all work so well. Again, this is Andrew Browne, one of the retina specialists at the Gavin Herbert Eye Institute. Thank you for joining us today for AMD Info Bites. If you have any changes in your vision or concerns about your vision, please consult your ophthalmologist, and we're happy to try and answer any other questions through AMD.org as well.